हेलो, हाय अनन्या।
हाय हाय, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड, थैंक यू। व्हाट अबाउट यू?
या गुड मॉर्निंग. आई एम आल्सो डूइंग गुड, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर आस्किंग. सो हाउ इज द डे गोइंग फॉर यू?
हाँ, इट इज गोइंग वेल एंड एज यूजुअल वी कैन से बिकॉज़ टुडे इज वर्किंग डे एज वेल।
राइट, ओके. सो आई एम मीटिंग यू आफ्टर सम टाइम, राइट?
आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग गैप।
Yeah, I think so. So what were you doing all these days? Were you taking classes or were you busy in something else?
Yeah, I was doing something else, and yeah, I have taken this session after a long gap.
Okay, makes sense. All right. So tell me, how is the like what is the condition of English right now? Like, what's happening? Are you facing some issues or what's happening?
I think now I'm able to speak, but still I make some mistakes in some of the random things, and some of the things I'm not clear maybe. So I have got some this kind of feedback from other Twitter as well. So yes, I just want to know that where I'm doing and where I'm lacking so that I can improve those things only, particular
Right,
things.
absolutely. So we are going to do just that. We are going to talk a little today, and I'll see where you're making mistakes so that I can give you some feedback based on that so that you can work on that. Okay, later on. But before we start, do you have any question, anything that you feel like you're facing problems in?
Yes, and one more thing, I feel about myself when I speak and I make sentences as well. So I think my sentence structure is not good as compared to like fluent or expert. So I feel like this.
Okay. So what do you consider a good sentence? Can you define a good sentence for me?
Okay, so maybe sometimes I make sentence like very for one thing I'm just making 3 to 4 sentences to elaborate the thing, or I'm not using particular good advanced vocabulary in that place, so that's why maybe so I consider like this.
Okay, so vocabulary maybe is one. So we can obviously see how we can develop that. I had talked to you about that book, right? Word Power Made Easy, if I'm not wrong. Had I told you about that book?
No, I
No.
think.
Okay. So there's this book that can help you with your vocabulary problems as a beginner. It's called Word Power Made Easy. Okay. It's by Norman Lewis, Word Power Made Easy. You can find a PDF copy as well. And I think it's very easily accessible, and it's a very good book that way. So you can probably take a look at that. It helps to develop vocabulary as a beginner because it has all these exercises given after all the chapters, which I feel are very necessary and important. Okay.
Okay, I'll check it out.
Can take a look at it. And the first chapter basically examines your current vocabulary standard and gives you some tips based on that. So you can look Okay. So today we are going to do some obviously activities first, like usual, and then we are going to go to the topic, which is extracurricular activities for the day. So we're definitely going to talk about that. But before we start, we are going to talk about some other things, do some other activities, and then go to that. Okay?
Okay, fine.
All right. The first activity that I'm going to do with you today is a storytelling activity. Okay? Now, what is this storytelling activity? I'm going to give you 4 keywords. Okay, 4 words that are going to become the, there are elements in every story, right? These 4 words will become some of the elements in the story. Like if I give the word pen, you have to make sure that pen is included in your story. So the 4 words that I give you have to be included in the story. Other elements you can include as per your choice. Okay. And you have to make a story out of it. You can use your copy if you want to make, sentences or note down points or whatever. I'll give you 2 minutes for that, and you have to come up with a story with a title and a moral if possible. Okay. Clear? Understood? Okay. So are you ready? Should I give you your 4 words?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. The first is rainbow.
Rainbow.
Rainbow. Yeah. Okay. Your second word is boy.
Boy.
Mm-hmm. Your third word is grandfather.
Mm-hmm.
And the last one is kite.
Kite.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. So take your 2 minutes. See what can you kind of build up from these 4 words. Add whatever details you need, but these 4 need to be there.
Okay. Okay, I can try.
Okay. That's okay. So what's the title of your story first?
Bond between grandfather and child.
Bond between grandfather and child. Okay.
Okay, so we can start. There was a boy named Raju. So he was very loved one of his grandfather, and he was a pampered boy of his grandfather. Mm-hmm. So he always pampered by his grandfather, and his grandfather always used to fulfill all his dreams, mm-hmm. Whatever he was saying. So. Mm. So one day he was insisting to go out for going somewhere. So he usually wanted to get a kite so that he can fly. So because he had seen some of his friends already had kites. So he also insisted his grandfather that he also want this kite. So he went outside with his grandfather to buy a kite. So after walking some distance, suddenly rain has started, and they had to they worried how they will come back to home, and after then they thought if they can wait for some time and when the rain will stop so that they can come back to home. And and the boy was also crying because he didn't get his kite as well. So when rain stopped, so he saw a beautiful rainbow in the sky. So he was very happy after watching rainbow, and he forget about the kite like he wanted to buy. And he told his grandfather that he is happy after watching this rainbow. So and now he don't want this kind of kite because he already saw a beautiful thing in the sky, and he was praising about this thing, and he thanked his grandfather to come with him and to see a beautiful rainbow in the sky. And after some discussion, they came back to their home.
Okay, and what's the moral of your story?
Moral is that it doesn't matter. Sometimes we love materialistic things, so it generally don't happen. You can find your happiness in some other way also.
Right. Okay, that's great. Good job. Okay. Now I have some observations. Firstly, great story. Good job. My voice is echoing, sorry. Yeah, good efforts given into the story, but some things that I found. Firstly, you are using a lot of fillers like so, like, that's happening again and again. Okay, specifically so I could hear a lot of times. So you're using so as the the only linking word. There are other linking words that you can explore, like however, furthermore, moreover, additionally, also, apart from that, there are a variety of linking words. Just try to explore those maybe from the internet. See what are the words that come up to you and try to use them in your sentences. Okay? Those are going to help you to solve this problem with, and try to, it's always important to give full stops, even when we are speaking. We sometimes tend to just continue the sentence again and again and again without stopping anywhere. Stop somewhere. Give a full stop. Make a sentence. Then start the next sentence. And after that, this happened. Then this happened. Okay? So that's very important to have a proper structure in our mind. Number one. Number two is, you were narrating in the past tense, which is absolutely, correct. But sometimes you were using continuous tense and simple past tense together. Like his grandfather always used to give him whatever he was insisting. Nothing is technically wrong with this, but it's always better to stick to one form of the tense, specifically in the same sentence. Like his grandfather used to always give him whatever he insisted upon or whatever he wanted. Instead of whatever he was wanting, he wanted is better. Okay? All right, so try to stick to the same form of the tense in the same sentence if possible. Okay? Number three would be, you said insisted his grandfather, insisted to his grandfather, insisted to, okay, or insisted that his grandfather bought him the kite or whatever it is, okay. Then you said rain, suddenly rain has stuck, that is present tense, right? We're using past tense throughout, then has is not required. Suddenly rain started, just go with simple past tense, okay, suddenly rain started. Then you said suddenly he watched rainbow or something. You said like that, the verb I don't remember, but it should be the rainbow. Okay, watched rainbow, it should be the rainbow, but because we're talking about a specific thing, right? So that and the last one would be thanked his grandpa to come with him. With thank we do not use to, we say for. Thanked his grandpa for coming with him. Okay, this would be whenever you say thank for something, not thank to some. We don't even thank to someone. We give our thanks to someone or we thank someone, but we thank someone for something. Okay? Always. Otherwise, very good. Do you have any question till this part?
No, I got it.
Perfect. All right. Okay, now we are going to do our second activity. The second activity is also going to be a speaking activity, but it's going to be an opinion-based piece. So I'm just going to ask you your opinion about a statement that I'm going to give, and you have to basically give me your opinion about that. So the statement is, again, you can take maybe 1 minute to think about the points you want to say, but ideally have an introductory line or two lines, then have the body in which you give your opinion, reasons, examples, then conclude with the last sentence. Okay? So your topic is, school children should not be given homework. So you can either say against this or in favor of this. School children should not be given homework.
I can say.
Yeah. Are you ready? That's great. Yeah. Go ahead, Lynn.
Okay. So in my opinion, students should be given a homework. Because you know, they are doing studies and they what they have learned in school, so they should be given homework so that they can, you know, understand and they can revise what they have learned from school, and they can revise all the things and they can study in at home as well. But if they are not given homework, so they will think like, I already done study in school, so I don't require anything to study now. And I think we should not give too much homework, we can say, like more. But yeah, we should give at least some of the homework so that they can understand what they have learned.
Right. Okay, that's perfect. All right, good job. Okay, now two things actually. The pronunciation is school, not is school. Okay, school.
Can you say it again?
School. Not school. The E sound comes from
school.
Okay, yes. School, exactly. The next thing would be, you said that they would think that they have already done. If it's past participle, if you're using it in the sense of past perfect or present perfect, there should be have or had, right? So they have already done. So that should be. Okay, clear? So that boundary needs to be there. I mean, boundary has been that boundary of placing the right word should be there. Otherwise, all good. You gave your reasons very prominently, I think. So good job. Now we are going to go and talk a little bit about the topic, which is extracurricular activities today. So we are going to talk about that. But before we start, till this portion, do you have any question, anything that you did not understand?
No, I just want to ask, you have seen my sentence structure. So did you find I can speak better than this?
If you work a little on the fillers, that's one thing, because you're using a lot of fillers. So that has to go away. And apart from that, the stray mistakes that are happening, like articles, prepositions, tenses, if those go away, the sentence structure already would become much better. But otherwise, you're also doing, I think, pretty good sentence structure-wise. Don't think about the vocabulary specifically, because I think you're using good words. But just work on the grammatical errors. Just see that those do not happen as much.
Okay, fine.
All right. Anything else?
No.
No. Okay, all right then. Okay, let's start then. The first question that I have for you is, could you tell me a little bit about your experience in school and with extracurriculars? Did you, kind of engage in certain extracurricular activities? If yes, what are your memories associated with them?
Okay, so to be honest, I was a very studious girl since my childhood. So yes. I usually not, I haven't participated in such kind of activities much. Hmm. But yeah, when I was very young, around... Hmm. Till 8th standard, I participated in some of the activities like dancing, singing, and some kind of different activities like salad decoration and something running like this. So I participated in that kind of activities. And yeah, it was really a fun activity that time. And I enjoyed a lot. But, when I grown up, so I don't know why I left all these things because of maybe I don't have this kind of courage to face this kind of stage, and I have stage fear as well. So till my college, I think I haven't participated in other activities, extracurricular activities.
Right. All right. Two things is that you said that I was studious girl. I was a studious girl. Okay. I was a. And the second thing is, I haven't participated. I did not participate, or I hadn't participated. So you have to use past tense. Okay, not have it. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, great. Now the next one would be, do you think extracurricular activities are important? If yes, why?
Yes, it is important. And I believe that it should be mandatory also in schools and college also. Because now I face a lot of difficulties because in most of the things like this, it improves your decision making. It improves your personalities in different way, like leadership quality, teamwork, and you improve your self confidence also. So I think it should be. It is important, especially when you are a child. So we can grab the thing very quickly, and we can learn from this kind of activities a lot. So it will help you in future, especially when you are coming into the. Like companies or in your career, it will help you a lot.
Right, I understand. Okay, great. So could you maybe give me some examples of extracurricular activities that you feel are very important or that should be there?
Okay, for example, we should engage in some of the sports also, because it helps you to find your passion also, whether you are fit here, because some people think what career they have to choose if they have passion in sports and dancing and singing. So because of this extracurricular activities, they will get the opportunity to know themselves better. So this kind of, and some other like voluntary work, teamwork, we can do such kind of activities so that we can build this kind of habit, leadership quality we can enhance.
Right. Okay, that's great. Now, do you think one can make a career out of this extracurricular activities?
Yes. If someone truly want to, have interest in something, they maybe some people have interest in dancing. So if they are getting this kind of opportunities in their school time or college time, so they can understand like, yes, they are fit here or not. If they are really, doing great in this field, so definitely they can make career as well in the same field.
Right. Okay. Understandable. And do you think, can we kind of let go of these activities ever? Where can we have a school where there would be no activities extracurricular? People only come to study and go home after studying.
No. I don't think so. Because now I'm struggling for this thing. And I feel like why I hadn't joined this kind of activities in my time. So I really miss this thing.
Yeah, if you could go back, what would you like to join, or what extracurricular activity would you like to take part in?
I want to join such kind of voluntary work so that I can, you know, build my confidence level. Still, I lack here. I don't have this kind of courage that I can talk in public and all. So definitely I want to try this thing.
Okay, all right. Makes
and sense. I love dancing as well. So if I'll get the chance, so definitely I'll try.
You did not dance in school as well, school or college?
I did till 8th standard only. And after that
you stopped because boards.
Yeah, you can say.
Okay. And what about college? You did not dance in college as well?
No, because as I told you, I was a studious girl, so I had more focused on study and study only.
Right. But now if you could go back, you would have changed that, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, makes sense. Okay, all right. So those are the questions that I had for you today. Very good answers. As I told you before as well, you have to work a little on decreasing your fillers. Number one. Number two would be prepositions and articles. Revise those chapters if you can. Try to see if there are theoretical things that you don't understand. Go through those, like thank someone for something. So those things try to re-clarify, and also work on your tenses a little. So this would be the three things that I would give you, you know, suggestions about more summatively, and the other specific suggestions that I've given here or there, just work on those and talk every day. That's very important. Don't leave a gap. It's very important that you keep on talking, be it whatever. Just take 25 minutes out of your day and talk, if not, and practice at home as well. If you just give up on that connection, then it would be difficult to survive or sustain that, whatever you have learned. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Do you have any question that I can help you with?
No, I think it generally happens when you have to think or have to speak suddenly. So we already know tenses tool as well. Like, yes, we have to just have our hands.
Yeah.
We already know. That's but correct. That's we can correct. Say that lack of practice, or maybe we are not more conscious about what we are saying. We are just saying because of practice sometimes. It happens.
Absolutely. That's absolutely. Just work on that, and otherwise I think you're doing good. Okay, I'll see you soon.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for joining today. Bye-bye. Have a good day.
Thank you. Bye-bye.